Good evening, everyone. Today we are over here to discuss about Panchkarma, need of the day. Now here the need of the day stands for Dincharya. Dincharya, as in the last lectures we learnt about Rutucharya, similarly we will be concentrating on certain aspects of Ayurveda or Panchkarma, certain procedure which can be utilized daily for the maintenance of health. That is first prayojan of Ayurveda, first aim and objective of Ayurveda, ki you should maintain the health of an healthy individual. Also Panchkarma can be utilized for curing the illness, but that's a different part which has to be done under supervision. Now what does Panchkarma itself specifies? Ki Pancha stands for five and karma are the procedures, right? So it is inclusive of five procedures. But I would like to specify ki these are the important five procedures. But again we have got Purva Karma prior to Panchkarma, that is jo while doing Panchkarma uske pehle karna hai, and Pashyat Karma, also Anu Karma, that is small karmas. We'll come gradually to it, but today we'll concentrate on this thing. Now Vaman means emesis, ki that is your given medicine, and made to vomit, that is Vaman. Virechan, purgation, you give medicine to, you know, develop loose motions. Basti in simple term like enema, but in from allopathy point of view, enema is always to clear your bowels. In Ayurveda, enema is not only to clear your bowels, it's a mode of administration of medicine. So as you have oral medicine, intravenous, similarly you have basti. So we have oil, kadha, different things, chas, milk, everything. Rakta mokshan, rakta is blood, mokshan is letting. So blood letting, which is generally used in blood disorders, and specifically where, in case of vata rakta, that is where uric acid has raised, so you get burning sensation along with pain. So is the preferred one. Now Nasya I have written in different color. The reason is that today we are going to talk about Nasya. So as I said, ki basti is a form of route of drug administration. Similarly, Nasya is a form or a route of drug administration. So in simple terms, Nasya stands for Nasa. So you administer medicated oil, ghee or any decoction, dry powder through the nostrils. So I would first like to demo, and then we'll go ahead with the do's, don'ts, indication, contraindication and the benefits of Nasya. So I would like you to help me. It's a very simple procedure. Nasya has been mentioned in Dincharya. So it is a type of procedure which should be done daily, and you can do it on yourself. Okay. Now I'll be demonstrating over her, but this is the way you can do it yourself at home as well. So you have to just lie down with a pillow over your knee. Aap thoda upar aa jao. Bas. See, the pillow is at her scapular region, at her shoulder. So she develops this position. Mundi thoda aise karo. This position, okay? And then with clean hands, you can use a dropper or a sterile gauze. I would prefer if you use a glass dropper, because we are using medicated oil. So there should not be any interaction with it, okay? Now it's very simple. I'm using a gauze piece with a regular Anu tail. Sits. Ek naak ban karke. 2, 3. Andar saans le lo. Aur khud se aise rub karo aap. Aise upar.
One drop.
2 to 3 drops. Or 5 you can administer. And you have to just. 1 minute. Inhale. Rub this way. You will feel ki it's coming into the throat. Similarly. And you have to always keep your eyes closed. See. 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale. And this is low. And this thing can be done by herself as well. Aap khud se aisa karo. Okay. And last mein aise. गले में आया नहीं आया, इनहेल इनहेल आया, सो इट केम्स इन टू अ थ्रोट. लेट अर कीप लाइंग ऐसे. आफ्टर डूइंग दिस यू नीड टू लाई डाउन फॉर 2 to 3 मिनट्स. ओके एंड देन यू कैन टर्न ऑन वन साइड. कोई भी एक साइड टर्न हो के आप उठ सकते हो. Thank you. So this was the way to do Nasya. That is administration of the nasal drop. So as we conducted in her, you can do it yourself. Lie down, close one nostril, take a dropper, keep your eyes closed, put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, inhale, rub it upwards, and then from the opposite side. Okay? From other side. The same side where you are administrating. Okay? Now. आप गार्गल कर लो ना वो गले में इसलिए. हाँ दैट्स व्हाट वी विल डिस्कस नाउ. वी गॉट इट डेमोन्स्ट्रेटेड फर्स्ट सो इट बिकम्स इजियर फॉर विल बी किट अप योर डंडन. तो द रीजन आई गॉट इट डेमोन्स्ट्रेटेड सो दैट यू कम टू नो कि व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट. ओके ये सब हम धीरे धीरे सब लेंगे. द रीजन फॉर टेकिंग पंचकर्मा दैट व्हाट वी वर डिस्कसिंग वाज कि पंचकर्मा वाज यू नो मेड और इन्वेंटेड फॉर द वेलनेस एंड सेकेंडली इलनेस. तो बोथ द थिंग्स. नाउ द प्रॉब्लम इज कि पीपल कंसिडर पंचकर्मा एज अ मसाज. दैट मेनी डॉक्टर्स यू नो आई हैव टू फेस दिस कि पीपल रिंग अप एंड कॉल माय रिसेप्शनिस्ट की वो मालिश वाली डॉक्टर आई है क्या. फ्रेंकली दिस इज वॉट इट हैपन्स बिकॉज यू नो अ पर्सन वेन गोज देयर कि मुझे ठीक लगा आप भी उनके पास जाओ तो यू गेट रेफरेंसेस. तो वॉट डे से कि नो सिंस वी आर यूजिंग ऑयल सो इट इज मसाज. बट पंचकर्मा इज नॉट ओनली मसाज. बेसिकली इन आयुर्वेद देर इज नोवेयर मैंशन कि यू शुड डू दैट मसाज थिंग. तो अभ्यंग या ऑल दिस थिंग इज जस्ट एप्लीकेशन ऑफ ऑल. देर इज नो विग्रस मसाज. मसाज वॉज द रॉन्ग टर्मिनोलॉजी विच वॉज यूटिलाइज. सो दैट वॉज द रीजन टू फोकस इट. नाउ नस्य पे वापस आएंगे हम लोग. ओके दिस इज नॉट ओके. एक मिनट. कंफर्टेबल हो आप? हाँ. नाउ एज सर आज कि वो यहाँ पे जाएगा दवा कि यहाँ पे जाएगा. नाउ एज पर आयुर्वेद नॉस्ट्रल्स आर कंसिडर्ड द गेटवे टू ऑल द इलनेस विच अकर अबाउट द क्लेविकल. नाउ यू हैव टू गिव मी द नेम विच आर द इलनेस दैट अकर अबाउट द क्लेविकल. गर्दन के ऊपर से कौन कौन सा बीमारी हम लोग को होता है? राइट. वर्टिगो, हेडेक, सोर थ्रोट, ear problem, nose congestion or running nose, either or. Okay, so all this are simple. Then again headaches are related. If we take, we go into depression, loss of memory, that is again brain related disorder. So Nasya acts on all this disorder. So whatever the medicine is being administered, definitely some amounts comes to into your throat because we have got a nasopharynx ka ek root. But similarly if you see a skull, so brain ke liye nostrils are attached to the upward portion as well, that is the cranial portion. So wahan se brain hota hai, so it goes into the brain as well. So there was a trial taken, I will discuss about. There was a patient with XYZ patient with psoriasis suffering since almost last 10 years with psoriasis, and he consulted all the good doctors, all the good physicians, allopathy, ayurvedi, homeopathy, everything. Now, then he went to some XYZ, dusra Ayurvedic physician. He said, continue all your medicine as it was advised by the previous Ayurvedic doctor. Just start Nasya with the oral ghee, with the ghee which he was supposed to take orally. Panchatikta Grit is generally advised. He said, just start Nasya with this. Within 1 month, the psoriatic rash disappeared and is better till date. The reason is what happens, you know, when you do Nasya, so it indicates your brain ki this is the medicine which is going to act on so and so disease, and this is the medicine which is going to come internally. So the brain advises the intestine ki start a good quantity of absorption and take it. In Ayurveda we have got strotas, that is channel. So you run this medicine along the raktavaha strotas or mounsavaha strotas. Say if somebody has got skin disorder, to take it through rasavaha strotas. Somebody has got joint pain, so brain advises, nahi, take it to asthivaha strotas, that is bone ka thing. So in this way Nasya is effective. So abhi is that's what in simple terminology ki agar wo brain ko stimulate kar sakta hai ki orally jo medicine aane wala hai, you need to absorb it properly and work along those channels. So just imagine how would be its efficacy over the mental disorder, everything I'd say, stress, depression. So these are the indication. Okay, generally Nasya I'd say it was advised only for hair fall and some amount of sinusitis, but again in sinusitis I would always say don't do it yourself, always consult a physician. The reason is sinusitis is inflammation of the sinuses, right? But usme do cheez hota hai, whenever we have got cold we get running nose or congestion. Now the medicine, this was something related to dhinacharya. Yeah, this can be used for cold, but again the medicine changes. As I said, we can use liquid, we can use ghee, we can use oil, medicated ghee, oil, liquid. We can use churna.
No, that is for intake.
Nee, nasya se, nasya se.
Nasya, one is anu and another.
Nee, anu tail is one of the medicine which is used for nasya. We can use brahmi grit, keshri grit, everything can be used. Kumkum adi tailam. For what? As I said, abhi jaise IV se, आपको विटामिन फॉलिक एसिड का इंजेक्शन दे सकते हैं, B12 का दे सकते हैं, यू कैन पेन किलर्स दे सकते हैं, एंटीबायोटिक्स दे सकते हैं. सिमिलरली फ्रॉम हियर यू कैन बी गिवन मेनी थिंग्स. सो बट व्हेन इट इज कंजेशन देन डेफिनेटली व्हाट विल ऑयल डू, व्हेन वी गेट सोर थ्रोट एंड वी ईट भजियाज, व्हाट हैपन, इट इंक्रीजेस इट, एनहांसेस इट, राइट? सिमिलरली इफ वी हैव गॉट कंजेशन देन डेफिनेटली वी कांट गो अहेड विद ऑयल और घी. Yeah, in some sensitive people, okay, ghee is advisable because they can't bear the churna. Naak se powder lena is difficult. But then again, those particular powders are used to make that medicated ghee. So it enhances the activity. So whenever it's related to illness, I would never say, get it done yourself. No. In Ayurveda, Nasya, besides Panchakarma, it has been mentioned in other part, that is Dhincharya. So that indicates ki Nasya is something which is to be done daily. Now everybody will think when to do it. This is from a wellness point of view. Matlab roj karna hai aur healthy individual ko karna hai. Illness ka we will leave it to the doctor. You go to the doctor, he will decide kya karna hai kya nahi. So when to do Nasya, so there are many kal mentioned, 14 I think so. So usme se it was ki you can do it before bedding, post bedding. There was one kal mentioned before going out of the house. Ghar se nikalne ke pehle you have to do Nasya.
Anytime.
Din mein ek hi baar bhi kiya to it's okay. Ha, that's what I want reason from you. Why it could be? Some simple logics. We are doing Nasya with tail. Anu tail or anything.
To absorb some pollutant
and... correct. You're going a bit correct. See, nostrils mein everybody has got nasal hair. You feel that? So, what's the function of the nasal air? It acts like a jhadu. Matlab it all wo kachra, grab all the dust or the particles, right? Abhi kuch chipchipa hoga, if something is oily, so you know it gets sticks to it. Correct? So, when you step outside, there is a tendency ki this polluted air or any dust particles can enter your body through your nostrils. So if it is lubricated, the first thing was lubricated. When you go out, you get exposed to dry air and it gets parched. So first thing was lubrication to prevent the parchedness. Second thing is ki, since the nostril hair acts like a jhadu or the broom, so they will absorb the dust particle and they will stick very well to the lateral wall of the nose. So because of which they won't enter your respiratory system, because we inhale through nose and exhale through the nostrils, right? So that is carbon dioxide andar isse ja raha, oxygen andar ja raha hai, that is pran as per Ayurveda. So the pran has to be very pure, as we say, the drinking water has to be very pure. Similarly, pran, the air, the oxygen has to be very pure. So that was the reason ki when you step out of the house, you do nasya and step out. So ye do reason. What could be the third reason from your side? Anything? Thoda bahut act as a coolant to the brain. Thoda bahut. But Anutel has got herbs which are a bit warm. Now she will share. Aapne gale mein aaya wo. So this is one of the thing. Abhi wo gale mein aaya, then nikalne ke liye kya karoge? Garara, gargle, right? So post nasya, naturally we are going to gargle, right? So jo bhi jama hua congestion hai, it will come into your throat or it will get relieved off, and you need to gargle and spit it out. Gargling is with lukewarm water and salt, so it comes out easily. So what you did, you cleared the air passage. So when you go out, you're going to walk, you're going to do any activity, and you need more amount of oxygen or more amount of energy, right? So for more amount of energy, when we run, you know, we breathe faster. We need more energy. Similarly, when we are going out, you know, the activity as compared to rest is going to increase. So our body should have a clear passage. If there is a traffic,
blockages are removed.
Matlab wo traffic jam clear ho jata hai. So you, aise subah, how do you feel while traveling, early morning or late night? It's very clear and you feel ki haan acha hai karke. Similarly in this way, so it clears the airway passage, especially nasal to throat tak ka. Okay, now gargling ka bhi similar effect hota hai. It clears the throat and all, because the toxins is accumulated over here. So these are the three important benefits if we do it daily, and especially while stepping out of the house. So how do you do it? Nasya kiya, gargle with lukewarm water. Then there is a vidhi called as dhumpan, but we'll come to it later. Now, these days many of us are suffer from congestion, cold and all this thing. And so, abhi from Panchakarma point of view, this was from daily regimen point of view. So, nasya, before doing nasya, as I said, there is called something called as purva karma, something which you should be doing prior to the main procedure. So, in purva karma, you need to take any lubricating agent, oil, ghee, whatever suits your skin, and you need to apply on your face. In a manner, ki how the muscles go. So this has to be done by the Vaidya or a Panchakarma trained therapist. Again, we have got sinuses over here and here, right? So what they do, ki they put some pressure point in such a manner ki those blocked sinuses are being drained off. So when you do nasya, wo pura gale mein aa jaye and bahar nikal jaye. So what we are doing, we are talking from sinusitis, yeah, headache point of view, because headache ka first reason these days is block, congestion or sinusitis, especially during this season. So they do this, that is snehan. Snehan means lubricating the face or the pores. Second comes swedan. Now swedan is normal, which we do regularly, taking steam. So steam lene se kya hoga? Externally you have applied oil and helped the sinuses to be drained off. Yeah, liquefy karna, basically pressure deke. And then when you take steam, it gets liquefied more. And so, uske baad jab aap nasya karoge, that is shodhan nasya, from detoxification point of view, so it would be easily for the patient to, you know, get eliminate or to be detoxified the toxins. And then comes, to ye verbally bata rahi, then comes paschat karma. So purva karma was snehan swedan. Pradhan karma, that is main karma, was nasya, and paschat karma was gargle and then dhumpan. So dhumpan is again a different topic in itself, jisme hum aayenge. Now what do you think, ki what should be the contraindications for nasya? Benefits mein to ho gaya, congestion, sinusitis, clears the air passages, oxygen intake capacity badhayega, hair fall, migraine, it helps in migraine and all that. But again you have to make that medicine in that form. So so from wellness point of view, daily nasya agar karna, you can use anutel, or many times it's said ki you can use sazu gai ka toop as well, even that would be helpful to you. Contraindication is ki
lung infections is the contraindication.
Ha, but nasya actually doesn't go.
But it might affect.
Okay, there could be chances, because especially while when you have lung infection, you might cough. So when you're having cough, you should not go ahead with Nasya, because then it disturbs the procedure. You know, while putting the nasal drops, rather than going into the throat, it can, you know, enter some other passages. So that is one of the contraindications. Secondly, if you're traveling a lot, or you've just traveled karke aaye, then you should not do Nasya. Okay? And third thing, if you're having running nose, because if you have got running nose, so running nose is a natural process of getting detoxified. Until and unless somebody has got CSF rhinorrhea karke, to wo chhod ke, baki it's a natural process of removing the toxins or the congestion or the sinus ka jo bhi drained out liquids rahega wo. So ye three other, if you're having fever, if you're vomiting, hiccups. I'll tell you, Nasya has been useful in patient with Bell's palsy, matlab facial paralysis as well. Because in Ayurveda, facial paralysis is due to vat. And in Nasya, what we are using, tail. In Nasya, we are using tail or ghee. So again, this is sneha, which reduces the vat. Just we have to modify it with the drugs, like Brahmi, Jatamansi, which will increase the nerve conduction and the circulation to build. So it has been very useful in vat disorder also, Nasya. And neti is something, since we are talking about Nasya, we will talk about neti as well. So now what's neti? As Nasya was cleansing of the nasal passage, so similarly neti has been useful in the same thing. I think so everyone is aware over here about the procedure neti, right? So if in case you don't have the vessel to do neti, so it is very simple. That's what we were discussing, ki you can just take lukewarm water and inhale, but just while inhalation you are tilted this way, and just you feel ki ye khatam hone hai, to turn this side, so it becomes easier for that passage to be clean. So, jal neti. Again, we have got sutra neti. Sutra neti is useful in patient with polyps. Again, for initial 15 days, it should be done under supervision. You have to lubricate the sutra well, then enter it. And the main trouble with the sutra neti is ki it will ticklish. So, you just start sneezing the time it touches your lateral wall. So, yahan tak you go very well. Aise thoda thoda karke, I've got, I think, so sutra. 1 minute. Initially everything, in fact Nasya also for the first time, I think so I got the sutra, Nasya as well, it broke off, so you have to sterilize this, thoda ye bada rehta hai, itna rehta hai, you have to sterilize
some
it.
Some people use rubber.
This is rubber wala thing, huh? And you get sutra as well, proper dhaga, kevaladam vagare mein bhi available hota hai, but sterilizing that dhaga is a bit difficult. Rubber, you can just put it into boiling water and get sterilized. You have to close your one nostril and enter. What happens ki this tip, the time it reaches over here, you start getting that sneezing. So it is something which is to be done with practice and under supervision. Even Nasya as well, when you're doing it for the first time, just don't start immediately. For the first time, do it in front of a vaidya or anyone who knows about the procedure. Say one of your colleagues who has been doing since last 5-10 years, and you want to do it from wellness point of view, then let him or her be there around, do it in front of them, and then you can do it regularly. Jal neti as well. Whenever you are starting with jal neti, initially it has to be done under supervision. Once you are accustomed to it, go ahead. Okay? So, main reason to take Nasya as a topic was that this is something which is very simple, you can do it home daily and very useful. Because nowadays everybody is suffering from either or sinusitis, a nasal polyp, post nasal drip. You know, what happens? Ki we complain to the doctor ki gale mein dard ho raha hai, ya aawaz baitha baitha lag raha hai. And you keep on getting from both point of view. Allopathy ke paas gaye to he will give you antibiotic. You go to a homeopathy, he will give you something to cure the respiratory stress over the throat. If you go to Ayurveda Charya, he will add sitopalladi churna and all this thing ki kantha pe kaam karega, muleti, which is favorite. Our family members, we get tips from the friends ki have ukara or have kali miri, muleti, all this thing. हाँ बट द मेन कॉन्सेप्ट इज कि यू आर गेटिंग अ पोस्ट नेजल ड्रिप बिकॉज द डिविएटेड नेजल सेप्टम और हैविंग अ डिफरेंट एनाटॉमिकल स्ट्रक्चर इज वेरी कॉमन दिस डेज तो रादर देन द फ्लूइड विच शुड कम्स आउट थ्रू योर नॉस्ट्रल्स इज स्लिपिंग बैक इन टू योर थ्रोट नाउ इट्स गेटिंग एक्यूमुलेटेड देयर एंड दो इट्स इन वेरी लेस क्वान्टिटी आई डू अग्री कि वो इतना ज्यादा नहीं है दो इट्स इन वेरी लेस क्वान्टिटी बट देन टू थ्रोट इज नॉट अ प्लेस नॉट अ स्टोरेज प्लेस ना सो इट्स नॉट इट्स राइट पोर्शन जैसे चाय में वी पुट शुगर एंड लेमन जूस में वी एड सॉल्ट अगर वो रिवर्स हुआ तो दिस वे तो वो रिवर्स हो गया ना तो वंस इट गोज डाउन इट गेट्स स्टैग्नेंट ओवर देयर एंड यू कीप ऑन गेटिंग सोर थ्रोट हॉर्सनेस ऑफ वॉइस एंड सिंस इट्स स्टैग्नेंट ओवर देयर इट्स गेटिंग एक्यूमुलेटेड यू स्टार्ट डेवलपिंग थ्रोट इन्फेक्शन यू रिसीव एंटीबायोटिक कोर्स और यू रिसीव मोलेटी सिटोपेलादी इट्स क्योर्ड But again after 15 days, so then you are termed as ki recurrent UTI, upper respiratory tract infection. Then macrolides, matlab azithromycin ya citopaladi se thoda aage badhke, wo doctor jayega kanak asav pe, ayurvedic hoga to, allopathy hoga to, you will go to amoxicillin plus clav, augmentin. So you are just stepping forward, but the root cause is the post-nasal drip. You can, yourself can check for the post-nasal drip, just stand in front of the mirror and do a bada aah. You can see the cough droplets hanging down or you know dripping down from here and you can feel that many a times while talking suddenly you develop hoarseness of voice no pain generally agar idhar gale mein infection hai to infection is inflammation so you should get pain na why you are not getting from the day one the pain why it's developing gradually so post nasal drip ke liye jal neeti certain pranayam which will come through and then nasya and jalniti is okay wo kar sakte I think so sutra niti will keep it only for patients suffering from deviated nasal septum matlab simple terms mein jiska beech ka haddi thoda tedha rehta hai ya one with the nasal polyp that is a growth into the nostrils but again nasal polyp first you get it examined and then you go ahead with sutra niti because there are chances ki what is a polyp it's a small tissue growth So when you do sutra neti, there's a friction created. Though you lubricate the tube, maine isko tel laga, but then too it is going to create some friction. So jal neti won't create that quantity of friction. So there are chances ki you might bleed. If I get continuous friction over here, say abrasion, so I might bleed, na? It might ooze similarly. No. So now from pranayam concept. So what we have covered till now is ki what is nasya, how we can do on routine basis, how it can be used in patient with suffering from sinusitis or cold congestion, post nasal drip and what other procedures you can use for the sinusitis, congestion or a nasal blockage because steam inhalation is one of the boon. You can take steam. That's very helpful. But again if you are doing nasya then jalniti has not to be done the same day. You can go alternate day. एक दिन यू डू नस्य देन यू डू जल नीति नस्य जल नीति ओके नाउ लास्ट वन इज सर्टेन प्राणायाम आपको फिर आना पड़ेगा आई थिंक सो एवरीबडी नोज नीति ना तो वी वोंट डेमोन्स्ट्रेट नीति विल डू सर्टेन प्राणायाम विच हेल्प्स टू प्रिवेंट पोस्ट नेजल ड्रिप हाँ ऐसे करना एंड साइनुसाइटिस में इट्स वेरी कॉमन ब्राह्मरी सबको आता होगा तो साइनुसाइटिस में इट विल बी हेल्पफुल कंजेशन अगेन सिमिलर टू साइनुसाइटिस के यहाँ पे जो हेड एक वगैरह होता है तो व्हाट वी आर डूइंग वी आर कवरिंग अपर ये नेजल कंजेशन वगैरह का बैठो बैठो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग एनी प्राणायाम यू हैव टू डू डीप इनहेलेशन एंड एक्सहेलेशन ओके सो दैट द एयरवे पैसेज इज क्रिएटेड एंड इफ यू फील कि इधर ऑफ द नॉस्ट्रल्स इज ब्लॉक्ड यू कैन जस्ट पुट प्लेस अ फिंगर एंड ब्लो हार्ड तो एक बंद होगा If you feel वो बंद है तो don't do anulom vilom with that nostril. Don't try to open it forcefully. Okay? तो सिर्फ लंबा सांस अंदर लेना है और छोड़ना है. Everybody can do along with her. हाँ. पीछे टिक्का लगा ले चलेगा. हाँ. लंबा सांस अंदर. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. You need to do 5 times. 2 more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Okay. Now the airway passage is clear. Now we'll come to Bhramari. You can do other pranayama as well, Anulom Vilom, but we'll focus on the important ones. So Bhramari is nothing. First you rub your hands, kyunki abhi thanda rahega. Create that warmth. Then, now, it is this position. Very gently, two fingers on the eye, ek upar, ek niche, and the thumb over your ear. Karo. Ha, anguta idhar rakho. Don't block your ear completely. Ha, aisa, ye aisa, ha, bas. Halke se, ha? Ha, barabar, correct. Don't block your ears completely. Now every
inside the ear.
हाँ नहीं इधर इधर सबको ये पीना है ना उसको सिर्फ प्रेस करना है ऐसा ओके नाउ यू हैव टू ब्रीथ इनहेल एज मच एज यू कैन एंड व्हेन यू वांट टू एक्सहेल मेक दैट हमिंग साउंड Again, inhale, deep breath in, and when you exhale, let that humming sound be created. Feel the vibrations over the sinuses. Once more, inhale, exhale, lag raha hai vibration. Don't open your eyes, keep your eyes closed, rub your hand, again create that warmth. Now the palm portion is to be placed on the eye, open your eye gradually. Okay, everybody felt that warmness, vibration, karte samay yahan pe laga. How many of you practice Bhramari at home?
Sometimes.
Never. Okay. See, you can. Chalega. Ha, that's even helpful. Aapko laga vibration. So that vibration which is created is because the air is flowing through the sinuses, which is helping us to get rid of the congestion. Okay. Other pranayama is very simple. Aap khade hoge. You have to just, ekdam simple hai, main ek baar dikha deti hu saath mein. Inhale, move backwards and then come down and this. See the neck position. Got it? This is the best pranayam for post nasal drip. So you have to just bend down, use your hand to hold your cup. Karoge? So upar jana hai, niche aana hai. हाथ को इधर पीछे रखना हाँ और मुंडी नीचे सी सी आर हाँ करो ना सी आर पोजीशन द नेक नीचे इनहेल एक्सहेल या एंड होल्ड एज लॉन्ग एज यू कैन एंड इफ यू फील होल्डिंग द ब्रेथ इज डिफिकल्ट यू कैन रीस्टार्ट द नॉर्मल ब्रेथ फॉर इनिशियल फिर रिलीज बस आ जाओ धीरे धीरे तो दिस यू नीड टू डू फाइव टाइम्स इट्स हाँ So, you know, when you go down, naturally that post-nasal drip is prevented. But this comes with practice. Okay? Ek aur aap karoge. Ab main aapko sikha deti hu. Can we just pause na? Okay? Haan, bas, barabar. You can keep a chadar or something below so your forehead. Generally, we have got the yoga mat. Hold as long as you can. A jaun par. So, these two are the प्रिवेंट पोस्ट नेजल ड्रिप बिकॉज एवरीबडी इज पॉपिंग एंटीबायोटिक मोलेटी योगी कंटिका मेनी थिंग्स फॉर देयर थ्रोट बट दे नेवर इन दिस नहीं इन दिस यू आर क्रिएटिंग प्रेशर ऑन द टमी ना तो प्रेफरेबली डन टू टू थ्री आवर्स पोस्ट मील और आफ्टर मील्स बिकॉज योर एलिमेंट्री ट्रैक इज स्ट्रेट ना इसीलिए Okay, so jaise we were working on the digestive system, today we are working out on the congestion ya nasal airways se related jo bhi disease rehti hai. Okay, so any queries or something more? Chalega. Thank you.